In Tigmod versus Make, what are the main new features? I will walk you through in this video. Hey, my name is Manuel and I'm the founder of TechFloor.ai and We Love Automation. In this video, I will show you the differences between Tigmod and Make and what you can expect from this makeover, pun intended, the makeover and the new platform. So here we go. This is the Tigmod dashboard like you know it and we have experienced it. And this is how the new Make will look like. You notice a little slightly different. So we have a different interface. The colors have changed and also the logo is different now. And here are some things that are not similar to what you have in Tigmod. So I will walk you through that now step by step. The first thing that we notice that on Tigmod, we just have an organization and then we have everything else in here. We have users which we can add to our account. And on Make, we have another tab here and that is called Teams, which means we have another layer of organizations or dashboards that we can handle. And that is Teams. So we can create unlimited amounts of teams inside one organization and then assign users to specific teams. They only have access to that team or they can have access to the whole organization. And then each team acts like an individual organization on Tigmod. So each team has its own connections, its own permission sets, its own webhooks and all these kind of things. And that way you can really separate if you're working in bigger companies, you can separate the team so not everyone has access to everything. And for example, the development is separate, the finance is separate, organizational stuff. And here, for example, I just created a team for YouTube and then it looks like this. You can see the operations used for that team. You can see the data transfer. This is not yet fully set up here. And then you can also manage the team members individually. So you can define if they should be an admin, a member, monitoring, operator, or a restricted member. And yeah, so then we have like the scenarios, like you know them. In each team, you have connections that are just for that team. So if I go into another team, for example, I don't know, that one, and then go into connections, this has a whole set of different connections or none at all, like in this case. That is one of the main new features. Of course, this comes at a cost. This is not for free, not included in all plans. And that's what leads me into the next part, pricing. How does the pricing change? So we are very aware of these plans. We have the free plan, the basic plan, the standard business and platinum plan inside Tigmod, and they all come with a certain amount of operations per month. And some more details, which I don't go into right now. The only thing that I'd like to mention here is the minimum interval, 50 minutes, 5 minutes. And then starting from the standard plan, we have 1 minute intervals, which we can run our scenarios in. Now, the pricing on Make is slightly different. Here we go. So we have the free plan, we have a core plan, a pro plan, and a teams plan. These are the features you can get. So we have different features, which you can see down here. The free plan comes with custom apps, unlimited users already, which is great. So unlimited users is new. It wasn't there in the free plan before. It comes with two-factor authentication, parallel scenario execution. I will come to that later. And real-time execution monitoring. So that's already very powerful. And it's limited to 1,000 operations per month. Now we have the core plan as well. These pricings are all based for 10,000, based on 10,000 operations per month, by the way. So we have the core plan, which is $9 per month. And this additionally gives you unlimited number of active scenarios. Then with the 1 minute interval, you remember the $9 plan on Tigmod, it had 5 minute intervals actually. So here you get it already the 1 minute interval, plus you get access to 300 plus Make API endpoints, which is awesome because that allows you to automate the automations and that's just insane. Now we have the pro plan. This also gives you a full text execution log search. I will show you how that works in a second as well, and gives you operations usage flexibility. That means these ones are built annually. So we could get an annual plan. And if you choose the annual plan, then you can say, okay, I have 10,000 operations. I want the annual plan. That means you have 120,000 operations per year and you can spend them throughout the whole year. So it's not on a monthly basis, but you can actually spend them throughout the whole year. For example, all 120,000 in December, and that's totally fine. So that is what the operations usage flexibility means. And you also get high priority scenario execution, which means if there are a lot of calls coming in, then your scenarios or your executions will be prioritized over those that are in low plans, like the free or core plan. If you want to try out Make Yourself and not sure yet how you like it, just use my link in the description below this video, which will give you access to 1 month of the pro plan for free. So no contract, nothing. You can just test it out and do whatever you want to do. You have access to the full text execution log. You have access to the API, so you can automate the automations and you can experience the pro plan for free for 1 month. Use the link in the description below and sign up now. And last but not least, we have the Teams plan. This is the one that I showed you. You get even a higher priority and you have the teams and the team roles, which I've just shown you before. And you can also create and share your own scenario templates. You can have in-house templates that are just private for your own team and they can use it. Now, this is the one vertical. And now we also have the more detailed comparison, which you can check out if you just pause the video at this stage. And then we have also the operations. Of course, people will need different amounts of operations. And here we have the pricing table. So for example, if you need 40,000 operations per month and you need the pro plan, then it's $53 per month. And the core plan, 29 for 40,000 operations. So that's 29 per month. Now, this is for the annual billing. And if you want to keep it on the monthly billing, then the pricing slightly increases. And these are the pricing for that one. Now, if you're fast enough, you can make use of that legacy pricing. So if you upgrade your existing IntegraMAT account, your IntegraMAT plan will translate into the legacy plan on the Make platform, which is the core plan, and the pricing will remain the same. So that is like insane. You get a ton of new features, but you're paying the same. For basic, standard, business, and platinum plan, you keep the operations and the monthly rate, and you will get on the core plan, which has these benefits over here. All right. Now I will get into some new features that you will notice on the IntegraMAT or Make platform itself. One thing that I want to show you is these functions. We all know them. Some people know them more, some people know them less, but they are super helpful in any kind of scenario. And we are using them a lot. And it's really hard to see, okay, how do they actually come together? Like, which function does this semicolon belong to? Is it from the sort, the get, or whatever? So that is really hard to see, and that is one new feature on Make. So if I check the exact same scenario on Make and hover over get, you see it underlines all semicolons or symbols that are connected to this function, which makes it a lot easier to find or to see what's going on. And then here for the sort, for example, it underlines what is connected to that one, the length, and here the other sort. And another change is if I remove that, previously on IntegraMAT, you were able to just close that one, but now it will show you an actual error message that there's something missing. There is a bracket missing, and it also underlines the function that has an error. So I just add that missing bracket here and press OK, and now I can use it. So that is one main new feature. Now, also, we all know these modules, how they look like, and this changes as well. How does it look like on Make now? This is how it looks like on Make. So it's a little bit different. So we have more colorful connection here. Then we have these arrows at the left side, which you can actually use to close them. That is especially helpful if you have a long list of fields. And for that scenario, I just want to access the filter and I don't need anything else. You can just close these ones to make it look better and to make it easier to work with. And again, we have this floor function underlined so we know exactly what belongs to it. This is one big change. Now let's get into the next change, and that is for the webhooks. Don't worry, when you migrate from IntegraMAT to Make, all your IntegraMAT webhooks will still be working, so don't worry about that. they are still running. And I will also upload a new video soon where I explain how you can migrate from Integuma to Make. So subscribe to my channel and turn on the notifications to not miss out on any of the videos that are coming out for Make. Now, we have this overview here of webhooks at the left side. And it was oftentimes very confusing because we did not know, okay, in which scenario is this webhook being used. Now, this has changed on Make. There is one new button here, and that is actually a scenario button, which means I can click directly on that button and I would get into the scenario that this webhook is connected to. One big change to notice though is that you can't have multiple scenarios with the same webhook anymore. So every webhook can just be connected to one single scenario. That's important to know. And that also brings me to the next change, and that is the parallel processing of webhooks. This is actually very powerful. What that means is if there are multiple data coming into your scenario, they won't be processed one after another, but they will be actually processed all at once. So as they come in, they will be processed instantly. How does it look like? Well, I prepared a sample scenario that sends a request to Integuma and then sends the same request to Make, and we will just compare. So let's see, on Integuma, it will run them individually. So it will run them one after another like this. And on Make, we can actually see this one over here. At the right side, you have this history log, and that's actually the live execution log. You can go through it. You have more details here. And when I run test scenario now, you can see here at the top, they're all being processed at once. So they're being processed live, and you can see the data running through here. If you have a bigger scenario which runs longer, then you can actually like click on them. And let me add something in here. Add a module sleep. So let's add a 5-minute sleep timer, or let's make 30 seconds. Save, going back, and now run this again. Okay, so now I can click into the actual scenario here and see the live data coming through like this. So I can switch between them, and then I can see the data running live through. So that's super helpful. It makes it helpful if you have a big launch, for example, where thousands of people are coming into your scenario or need to be processed at once. Then it's very helpful, and it speeds up the processing, of course. Now I want to show you another exciting feature, and that is the full text search. So on Integuma, like if you check that here and you want to find a specific execution log, for example, connected to a specific email or with a specific value, you would have to go through all of these ones individually, check the data. Okay, what happened? Where's this number? I don't know. Let's say I want to find this 31.25. And that's really cumbersome. So you have to go through all of them. But now on Make, you can actually use the full text search in the history. Note, this is only available starting on the Pro plan or above. You can use the full text search and paste the number in here. This is accessible with the shortcut Control Shift F on Windows or Command Shift F on Mac. And then you can put that in, and now you see all the values where this number appeared or all these runs. And you can just click on them and then get directly into it. So this one, for example, 31.25, and these are different values inside the same run. So you can see the number is the same. And then this one is another number, so it's another run. And here we also have the 31.25. And then you can go in here and you can directly see, okay, this is actually the scenario you're looking for. This is extremely helpful if you have Shopify orders, for example, and want to find someone by email and all these kinds of things. So yeah, really great feature. I've been requesting that for a long time already, and now it's here, so I love it. Thank you very much for watching this video. Subscribe to my channel and turn on the notifications so you don't miss out on any new Make features. And make sure to sign up for the Pro plan with a free account by just using my link below in the description, and you will love it.